Lebanon's Prime Minister-designate Saad Hariri has stepped down after he failed to form a new government. The country has been without a government for 9 months now and is facing an unprecedented economic crisis. For more, let's cross live to Zeina Khadr, who's in Beirut and joins us now on the phone. Zeina, the country needs a government. Why does it not have one? What more can you tell us?
Well, there is an intractable political crisis in Lebanon. You mentioned this country has been without a government for nearly a year. Saad al-Hariri was appointed last October. He has since not been able to form a government. His decision to step aside only complicates this political crisis. He made the announcement moments ago after meeting the president. He has been locked in a power struggle with the president. The two men have not been able to agree on the makeup and size of the next government. And it's not just that. They're both in disagreement on each one's authorities. Who has the authority, for example, to name a certain number of ministers? And Hariri was very, very blunt when he left the meeting with the president. Everybody thought that there could be some sort of last-minute 11th-hour deal to rescue Lebanon. You mentioned an unprecedented economic crisis. Hariri saying, it is clear the president's position has not changed, and we can't agree. I asked him, do you need more time? And the president told me, we won't be able to agree. So I told him, I am stepping aside. So Lebanon now in an open-ended political crisis with an unprecedented economic and financial crisis, which has impoverished more than half the population.
So Zeina, the country is fast running out of money. As you said, more than half the population are in poverty. We saw the aftermath of that devastating port explosion. Can they explain why the number of cabinet posts and who is in charge of what seats at what table is more important than the fate of the people of the country the two men are supposed to lead?
This is why there is so much anger in Lebanon. Politicians are being accused of working for their own interests and not the interests of the Lebanese people. You mentioned a cash-strapped government. The central bank is running out of foreign currency reserves. It's unable to import enough medicine, enough fuel. The international community is just as frustrated as the Lebanese people, because the international community is refusing to give these politicians a blank check. They've been telling them that you need to carry out reforms. You need to create a cabinet that is willing to fight corruption, because this time around, we are not bailing you out. And yet, these politicians are working for their own interests, ensuring that they control the next government. Because all these politicians now, they have their eyes on the upcoming parliamentary elections next year. They want to ensure that they're able to stay in power and cling on to power. But many people have been asking them, what are you fighting over? Are you fighting over a dead corpse? There's nothing left. The state is nearly bankrupt. And like I mentioned, the international community will not be released with funds. In fact, the international community, the United States, France, even Russia and Egypt, they have been trying over recent days to try to strike a last-minute deal, an 11th-hour deal, in order for Saad al-Hariri not to step aside. Because the very fact that he steps aside, it's going to be very difficult to appoint someone in his place. So the country could be without a functioning government until parliamentary elections are held next year.
OK, Zeina Khadr there, live for us on the phone from Beirut. We'll have more from Zeina in the hours to come. But for now, thank you very much indeed.